Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am sad. But before I get into my review, if you're new to this channel, hello and welcome. I summarize and review the latest by Anlesh and Sanchar, a couple of my episodes, say what I like, what I didn't like. And in this case, I can't really say what I think might happen next. But if you like these kinds of videos, like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe so we can meet on a weekly basis. Before we get into the Ezgi and Özgür storyline, let's talk a little bit about the other storylines. And after my review, I will talk about my feelings and my thoughts about by Anlesh and So first we have Cansu and Levent. Ezgi and Özgür find Zeynep at a taxi station because she wanted to go to her mother's. You can really see how much Levent loves Zeynep, and I kind of understood both sides. Like, I understood Levent's side because it is his daughter. Like, his daughter is everything to him, and for him to put his daughter first before Cansu, it kind of made sense. But then on the other hand, I felt really, really bad for Cansu because it was her dream. She had an amazing relationship with Levent, and finally they were ready to marry, or he was ready to marry her. So for it to end up like this, it was really hurtful, and I felt really, really bad for her, especially when he said, I will go to that park, but please stay here because I don't want Zeynep to have a certain reaction to you. So as I said, I really felt bad for them. Like, that storyline, it felt way too rushed, way too hard, in my opinion. Like, in this episode, you could really see Levent's love for Cansu. Like, he was so bored at home. He seeked advice from Özgür, and Özgür was like, my knowledge ends with the marriage. So everything before marriage, I'm fine. I can give you advice, but after that, I'm lost. I'm really sorry. And that's when Levent goes to Emre, so Pablo, and just vents to him. Just wants somebody to listen. Then them two playing PlayStation together or something like that. It was hilarious. And then Emre going but then coming back because there are no taxis, so he ends up staying over. And then at first he's like, I need the toilet, and then takes a bath. In the meantime, Cansu comes, hears Emre playing with those squeaky ducks, thinks that there's a woman. Levent desperately trying to prove to Cansu that it's actually Emre. And then Emre comes downstairs in Jansu's robe, like pink robe, and then him also putting out a leg. It was hilarious. Like, I loved it so much. And then after Cansu apologizes for everything, like accusing Levent of having a woman, Levent telling Emre to take off the robe, and then he was about to take it off, and I was like, what? But yeah, back to Cansu and Levent. I really felt bad for him. Oh my god. Like, before everything, like right after the wedding, she goes to Levent. Levent is trying to explain to her his situation, but is kind of overwhelmed. It has a really hard time to explain it to her. And then he's like, I didn't give Zeynep enough time to kind of get used to the thought of me marrying you. So let's take a step back. Let's get back to being engaged. And then she's like, I would take two steps back, we break up. You could really see Levent's pain in his eyes, and I don't know, like I said, I've kind of understood both sides. Like, why drag the engagement on if you know that it won't really happen? Because that child won't accept Cansu that easily. At work, like at the hospital, everybody was gossiping about Cansu and Levent. And then Cansu going on vacation, him trying to stop her, but then in the end she went, and that was it. Like, her just going away and him staying there. Like, it was so confusing. Like, this whole episode felt really rushed, and it was rushed. Then we have Deniz and Ozan. So their relationship, we were robbed of so many amazing Deniz and Ozan moments. Like, have you seen the pictures that Serkay, like the guy who plays Ozan, put on Instagram? Like, wow, them two together, they're so amazing together, and I would watch a series with them two in a heartbeat. Also, Deniz kind of confessing her secret to Ozan, it was so rushed and it was so anticlimactic. Like, I was like, girl, seriously, was that your secret? Was that the reason why you behaved that way with Ozan? Seriously. So I was kind of frustrated and angry at the same time, because they were by the seaside eating a durum. Then he's like, well, you wanted to talk to me about something, you can tell me anything, I don't mind, blah, blah, blah. And then she's like, I was married before. And he's like, you're not married now, are you? And she's like, no. And then he's like, okay, so what's the problem? Now one of us has experience in marriage. And I was like, really? Was that the secret? I thought she was like raped, or she had an abusive relationship, or something way worse. Because why would you cry when there's talk about children? Why would you cry? Just because you were married before? Like, I didn't get it. And that's another scene where you could really see that it was rushed just to have an explanation for her reactions and for her secret. And I felt like, oh, really? Anyways, it was really cute to see them off-roading with Özgür and Ezgi. And is there anything else? I don't think so. Then we can move on to Fitnat. So Fitnat meets up with her almost ex-husband, tries to record him to have some proof. While he's on the toilet, she sees a message he got from that woman he's seeing, and also the location. So she goes to that hotel, she catches them in bed. Oh my god, save him, they're filming them. It was so chaotic, so funny at the same time. Like, I have to admit, I'm going to miss Fitnat. Like, even though I hated her in the beginning, I loved her at the end, and she's so amazing, so I'm really going to miss her. So there we also don't really have a conclusion. Like, okay, she found her husband cheating again. So once again, like, a little thread hanging without a conclusion. And is there anything else? Gizem getting promoted from waitress to being a PR manager, and then at the end apparently being an accountant. Okay, so Özgür needing somebody who can handle all the media outlets, giving La Laguna bad press, and I kind of understood his situation that he needed a PR manager, but like I said, way too rushed. And I think that's all for the side storylines. Oh yeah, Yeşim, we only saw her once when she said that the videos that she has of La Laguna being pure chaos when it was hot then cold, and she will put them on the internet, and that's how Özgür got really bad press and La Laguna was trending. Yeah, that was the only time we really saw her. I think we can move on to Ezgi and Özgür. So Özgür confronts Serdar what he's doing at the wedding, and he's like, well, I'm a friend of Lavan's and I wanted to congratulate him, blah blah blah, but Ezgi told me that the wedding is cancelled. And then this whole recorder thing happened, so Fitnat needed some tissues, looked in Ezgi's bag, put the recorder out, a way to put the recorder somewhere else, which was like near her bag. But when Ezgi changed her clothes after everybody left, she only took her bag and the recorder was there. And I was like, oh my god, somebody will find it, will listen to it. And then while Özgür was somewhere, Serdar called Ezgi to see if she blackmailed Tolga already. And then she's like, no, she's not going to do that, blah blah blah. And then Özgür finding the recorder, Ezgi panicking, Özgür first blaming Emre, being like, oh, you're listening to people. Emre being like, no, it's not mine. And then Emre being really close to listening to the recording. Özgür saying maybe it's Tolga, but then Emre is like, why would Tolga hide it in plain sight? And then Ezgi says, well, it's mine because I always record meetings and it's from my old employer. Because Emre was like, why don't you record with your phone? Like, it was so confusing at times. So let's get this over with, kind of. And then we see Ezgi talking to Dennis about the recording because she's the only one who knows what she can do, blah blah blah. In the meantime, this whole Twitter trend about La Laguna is happening. Emre calls Ezgi to come quickly. Then when Özgür is reading all the bad press, Tolga is coming, and I have to say, I'm going to miss that guy. Like, some of the statements he had, like some of the things he said, were just on point. And when he visited La Laguna, he sat down, wanted a menu, and then had a little face off with Gizem, and Özgür got really angry confronting him, what is he doing here? And then he's like, I saw it on social media, so I came prepared, and I had to laugh out loud, not going to lie. He put on a coat, and then he's like, if it was boiling hot in here, I have some shorts, a shirt,
some flip-flops, and I was like, oh my god.
And then Özgür being like, I don't get angry with you anymore, I'm just feeling sorry for you, and then walks off, and Özgür is kind of confronting him, because before that Özgür was blaming Tolga for doing this whole social media thing, and he's like, no, it was me, you don't even have proof if it was me. And that's when Özgür takes out the recorder from her pocket. That's when Özgür is confronting Tolga, and he's like, he did nothing illegal with Lagabia, blah blah blah. She's like, well, what would you do if I had proof? And he's like, oh my god, I'm so interested what you have. But then Özgür is calling her, and then she walks away. And then we have this adorable scene on the terrace where Özgür and Özgür are talking. Özgür telling her that he has a really hard time to bring La Laguna to life, and he feels really tired, which he never felt working at Lagabia. So you can really see that he's not in tune with La Laguna. And then the next day, Serdar calls Özgür again, because he's like, oh, I saw all the bad press and I was so worried for Özgür. And then he's like, well, I'm so sorry you had to see my bad side, I want you to see my real side, the good side. Have you blackmailed Tolga already? And then he's like, maybe one day we will be back together, because I have to confess, I'm so in love with you. And I was like, oh my god, seriously, God, do you really think that just because you're confessing your feelings to her, she will run back to you being like, oh my god, I waited so long for you to say that, take me back? Seriously? And then the best thing was her telling him that it's not love, it's obsession, and then she's kind of hanging up on him, and then wants to throw the recorder away but doesn't. And then Gizem sees that there's a new trend and people are talking about Emre, and he's really excited. Oh, people are really talking about me. And he shows it to Özgür, and Özgür gets upset because of that, and that's when he switches to John David mode, the mountain man. He needs to clear his hands. He needs to go to the mountains. And Özgür is really concerned. Only Ozan knows where he's going, because he's always going there, just like John David. And it gave me really John David vibes, like basically Akenji Kush vibes, this whole camping trip, or parts of it. So then we see Özgür being in his natural habitat, kind of in the mountains, running around. Özgür being all shocked to see him camped out there. And then Ozan came prepared, also with a tent. And then Özgür is like, okay, hey guys, leave me alone, because Özgür can't see me so helpless, so he will come and help me. And that's what happened. So at first they're talking, blah blah blah, and then he's like, I love helping the woman I love. And I was like, oh my god. And then she gets kind of angry at him for not taking her with him, or like telling her his problems, and is like, I don't want to vent my problems, like have this whole negative energy around you, blah blah blah. So I really thought it was adorable of him taking care of her that way, but at the same time I'm like, dude, you're in a relationship, it's like teamwork, so maybe she can help you. But anyways, then Ozan and Deniz come. Then Ozan says that he forgot the food basket, so they have to fish, but they only have two fishing rods. And what I thought was kind of weird, the fact that Özgür was able to change her outfit, so suddenly she had like this red shirt on and a yellow jacket, like where did that come from? But anyways, after they ate, Özgür has an idea to go off-roading, because now he cleared his head, he's really relaxed, really happy. And then this woman that gives them the cars says, well, it's so good to see you back, Özgür, the last time I saw you, you were with Dagan. And I was like, what? Ozan and Özgür got so awkward, Özgür really getting jealous, but at the same time interested to see who that Deren was, because that woman said, well, you fit so well together, not long ago Deren was here and we talked a lot about you, blah blah blah. And then Özgür wants to find out more, so that woman tells her that Deren's nickname was Goat, and it was given to her by Özgür, and they fit so well together, blah blah blah. And that's when Özgür gets so riled up, so stubborn, kind of jealous. And if you look closely, Özgür is really enjoying it. And then they have this off-road trip, like Özgür going crazy. And if you look closely, there are some takes where you see Özgür not having a seatbelt on, and then the majority of the takes he did, but there are two or three takes he didn't have a seatbelt on. And the contrast of Deniz and Ozan driving and Özgür and Ezgi driving was hilarious, like Özgür going crazy, Ozan not really going that crazy, and then Özgür having to remove a log from the street and Ezgi insisting on her driving and then him giving her kind of a lesson how to drive that car and then her getting stuck in the mud. So it kind of reminded me of Sanem getting stuck in the mud in the woods and then Özgür trying to get her out of there, but then he falls back, gets all muddy, she goes out and then she falls on top of him, and all I can think of was that tissue box floating next to them and her hair getting dirty, like she didn't have them in the ponytail, like it was all over the place, her hair was everywhere. But then when they showed them together again, they were all clean. So yeah, it was funny, it was really adorable to watch them and then them taking pictures, because he was really adorable saying that he's happy that she's with him and then she's like, well, wherever you go, I will find you. And it was just such an adorable moment and I really want to see those pictures. Please, Bayanlish team, Özge or Can, please release those pictures. I really want to see them because they looked so adorable. Anyways, they're sitting by the fire and Özge being like, let's go sleep because we need to stay warm, blah blah blah, but then Deniz is like, Ezgi, can we sleep together? So Özgür has to sleep with Ozan and then Özgür is like, oh no, let's get back to the city because look, it starts raining. It was just so amazing, so adorable, so funny. Oh, what I forgot to say is that the detective that Serdar put on Deren Yilmaz to kind of bring her to blackmail Özgür with or something like that, so the detective was really close, but then towards the end of the episode he's like, no, she already traveled back to South America and she will only come back in half a year. So once again you could really see that they had a plan with that woman, but they had to really switch it off quite quickly saying that she's gone already, which was kind of stupid. But yeah, then after the camping trip, Özgür has a motivational speech in front of his staff saying that he wants to get La Laguna going, and that's when Tolga comes and is like, well, I got bored of La Gavia, you can have it back. And everybody was really confused. Özgür didn't really believe him, like, why now? Without a catch, what is happening? But then Deniz checks the contract and it seems legal, so they sign it. So now Özgür has La Gavia back and Tolga is like, okay, bye. So Ezgi calls Can to tell her the good news and she's outside. Tolga comes, congratulates Ezgi because of the blackmail he got from her and she's really confused. And then he's like, I didn't care if Özgür had this recording because he would be too proud, or I believe, yeah, too proud to use it. But with you, I didn't expect it from you. And then she's like, I didn't do anything. So then he pulls out a note and I really want to know what that note was saying, because it got Tolga to do what everybody wanted him to do. And it turns out it was actually Serdar who sent that note and the recording to Tolga. But anyways, Ezgi is really confused. Tolga doesn't believe her that she doesn't know about it, so he's like, of course you won't admit it because we're here, blah blah blah. And then him saying that he's only doing it because he doesn't want to end up in jail, and then walks off. And then when Ezgi goes back and everybody is like, well, let's go back to La Gavia, Ezgi confesses to Özgür this whole situation with Serdar and the recording, and I was like, oh my god, this is once again so rushed. But yeah, Özgür being really happy that she didn't use the recording, and then all of them being at La Gavia 2 days later, and Nevin and Ünal coming, Ünal overhearing Ozan and Özgür talking about they have to check everything because they don't want to do the same mistake they did in La Gavia, so they have to check everything if everything is all right. And now they kind of have money issues until they sell Laguna. And Ozan says, what if we take on another partner? And Özgür is like, no, I can't work with somebody who I don't know and I'm not familiar with. And then Ünal tells them, what if the person who can be your new partner is quite familiar with you? And then he says, what if Ezgi is the person? Because Özgür was telling Ezgi to kind of start her own business, work with him, blah blah blah, and she's like, no, I don't have enough money. And then Ünal tells Ezgi that they have enough money, they can give her to be a partner at La Gabia, and then she gets really excited. Ezgi of course accepts, and then they sign the contract. Emre is really excited and then asks her as the new boss if he can get a raise, and she's like, let's double it, blah blah blah, and he loves her for doing that. And then everybody is happily hugging, and the only one being alone was Emre, and I felt so bad for him, but it was so funny. And then we have the scene on the terrace between Ezgi and Özgür. Özgür kind of laying his feelings out there, saying that Ezgi should move in with him now that they're business partners, and then that they should go on a vacation to Italy. And if she remembers what he told her in the beginning, that a guy knows if he wants to marry a woman within the first 3 dates, and if the guy hasn't proposed after 3 months, you shouldn't be with him anymore, blah blah blah. And she's like, yes, I remember, blah blah blah. And then him saying that when he saw her in the taxi, he already knew that she will be his wife, but he only had to admit it to himself and to accept it. And then he proposes and she accepts, and I was like, oh my god, I'm so happy for them. And that's the end. And I was like, no, no, please, no. Why are you doing this? I felt so bad. I felt so sad, honestly. So that's the end of Bayanlish. I don't know what to say. It's really sad that it had to end that way. This is just my opinion, and I have to say, I think that it was a mistake for Fox to keep Bayanlish on Fridays. I think they should have moved it to Sunday or Saturdays, because on the weekends there's not that much of a competition. I mean, Kırmızı Oda is just a bomb. This series is killing every series. I thought that Her Kay would be a great competition for Bayanlish, but it seems like they have less rating than Bayanlish, and I was like, what? Like, this was number one for the last couple of years. So I was kind of shocked. Yeah, it was a bad move from Fox. That's all I can say. I think they should have moved it to Saturday or Sunday, so everybody would have been happy. Fox with the ratings, us for getting more Ezgi, Özgür, Ozan and Deniz. I also do think that maybe it was too forward thinking, too modern. Maybe it was just too Western for them. I don't know what else to say, because normally they go for the poor girl, rich guy, him rescuing her, or the other way around. But this time you could really see two mature people starting a relationship and him giving advice, and I think that advice kind of resonated with all female audiences all around the world. I really liked it, so I really do hope that, I don't know what book Ezgi was reading in the first episode, so I really do hope that Aslı would translate it. Yeah, what else? I think it was way too rushed. Like, you could really see that they had half the episode already filmed, pre-shot, ready to go, and then the news broke that they are cancelled, so Aslı had to come up with a great conclusion, kind of tying everything together without leaving anything open, but then at the same time staying in the 2 hours frame. So it was really hard. So respect to all of the Bayanlış team, to the actors, for bringing life to this amazing story. And like I said, maybe this story was just at the wrong time. It came out at the wrong time on the wrong channel. Maybe it was just heartbreaking to hear that it's getting cancelled. I've never witnessed such a drastic cancellation. I've witnessed a lot of cancellations, and all of them have been, okay, you have 3 more episodes till it ends, blah blah blah. But this was, next episode is the end, and I was like, how will they do it? They kind of mastered it, and all respect to them, but I think if Fox would have given them the chance to get 1 more episode, like in this episode kind of deal with the bigger problems, and then the next episode be a happy ending, a wedding with Ezgi and Özgür, maybe then a time jump seeing Levent, Cansu, Ozan, Deniz, Ezgi and Özgür with children all happy together, I would have loved that. But unfortunately we don't get it. I'm really excited to see what is in store for all of them, all the best, good luck to all of them. And yeah, my battery is flashing, I'm really sorry, I'm ranting on right now. All I wanted to say is it was an amazing series, I loved it so much. It has such an amazing potential to be even better if it was just on another channel, maybe on another day. But unfortunately, Fox didn't see the potential, and I'm really sorry, because apparently they can move series to different dates, because Örent Man would have been on Wednesdays, but now it's on Sundays or something like that, so the possibility was there for them to move Bionish to a different day. But they took up too many projects, it seems. So yeah, that's all I can say. I hope you liked my Bionish reviews. I really do hope that you still subscribe and watch my other reviews that I do, or future reviews that I might do. And yeah, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments your thoughts on this amazing last episode. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Ring that bell to be notified whenever I post something, and I will see you next time.